David here with Fig Boot on Pens, back again with another fountain pen review. Today, I have for you an interesting pen from Mont Blanc. It is a pen which was discontinued a few years ago, but was very popular for a period of time, and in my opinion, is still worth taking a look at. The name of the pen is the Bohème, and the distinguishing feature of this pen is that it has a retractable nib, as well as some other very cool features. What I'm going to do today is go over the parts and features of the Mont Blanc Bohème, talk about what I care for and what I don't care for about it, I'll show some measurements, size comparisons, and provide a writing sample. Thanks go out to Spencer, who is a viewer of this channel from St. Petersburg, Florida, who sent along this pen as well as a couple of others for review. The pen arrives in this fairly standard Mont Blanc box, and inside we have the pen. This is the Mont Blanc Bohème. Now, this pen was introduced by Mont Blanc back in around 1999, and it stayed in production until it was discontinued around 2014. Over that time, the line was very popular. Mont Blanc released dozens of different varieties of this pen in different colors and treatments and gems that were featured on the clips. This specific model here, I believe, is called the Platinum line. The pen is made from a black resin, as Mont Blanc markets it, their precious resin, and the trim is platinum. It's rather compact, but I wouldn't go as far as calling this a pocket pen, but it's not large by any means. Let's start by taking a look at the cap. On the end is Mont Blanc's traditional logo, a white rounded star, representing the snowy peak of the Mont Blanc mountain. Mont Blanc is the second most prominent peak in Europe. In regard to mountains, prominence doesn't relate to overall height, it relates to the measure of how high the summit of a mountain rises above its surroundings. Below the top of the cap is a clip band. The serial number for this pen could be found here on this band. And then we have the clip. It is a bit on the short side, but it's size appropriate for the cap. There is a little recessed flat portion at the end of the clip, and this is where on the other Bohème models the gemstone is affixed. This particular model did not include a gem, but the clip is the same as the other models, so that is where the gemstone would be. The cap is rather stubbish and angles up, with the widest part of the cap being at the very end, where it meets up with the cap band, which is angled and transitions down to the barrel. The barrel angles up slightly, with the widest part being close to the back here, then it tapers down a tad until we get to the end of the barrel, and there's a lot going on here at the end of the barrel. First of all, there is a platinum-plated band, and then there are some posting threads for the cap, and then we have a mechanism here on the end that we'll take a look at in a moment, and then the very end of the barrel has a slightly rounded resin circular insert. The cap unscrews with just over two rotations, and underneath, we have nothing. As you can see here, there is a very large hole where a nib would normally be. They didn't forget to install the nib, it's retractable. If you twist the end piece here, then the nib will extend. Now, this mechanism is kind of mind-blowing. It is incredibly smooth and very satisfying to operate. When you extend the nib, it's a very smooth motion, and then at the very end, you could feel the tension increase slightly and then decrease as the nib locks in place. If the nib isn't quite locked into place, if you put pressure on the end of the nib, it actually will retract back into the barrel, but when it's locked, then it won't retract at all. Now, you can operate this mechanism in two ways. You can remove the cap and then twist the knob like I've been doing, or you can post the cap, and the act of posting then will extend the nib as well. I don't find that the cap backweights the pen or throws off the balance, so I find it well suited to use while posting or unposting if you prefer. Now, there is no trapdoor or anything like that protecting the nib when it's retracted. It's just in there, albeit rather deeply. It sits about even with this band here. I liken it to like the vintage design of a safety pin. Even though when it's extended, there is plenty of room for the nib to fit inside the cap here. Let me show you. You can see that there is plenty of room for that nib to fit inside the cap. But there is a little rod in here that extends from the end of the cap, which is very hard to get a picture of, but it prevents you from capping when the nib is extended. So the intended design is for you to extend and retract this nib whenever using the pen. Okay, let's take a look at the nib itself. It is 18 karat gold. Some versions of this pen will have a two-tone nib. And as with all of Mont Blanc's nibs I have tested, this one is outstanding. And here's a look at the plastic feed. The section begins with a rounded flare, and the section is a bit on the thicker side, which matches up well with my personal tastes. The section angles up slightly and transitions into the traditional Mont Blanc band. On one side, it says Mont Blanc, and on the other side, it says Bohème. And the band is found in this unique location, right before a small step up to the cap threads and the rest of the barrel. The Mont Blanc Bohème is a cartridge-only pen. It accepts standard international cartridges. Now, you can purchase like little third-party mini converters. Personally, I've never been a fan of those small converters. At that point, I would just rather fill up an entry cartridge with the ink of my choice. But how the cartridge loads into this pen is rather cool. The back portion of the barrel hinges open in order to give you access. Now, in order to really appreciate this mechanism, it's best to see how it operates up close. So I'll show you that right after the size comparisons here in a bit. So stay tuned for that. You're going to want to see that. Overall, this pen for me is a combination of annoyance and fun. It's a bit annoying that in order to use this pen, you have to remove the cap and then either extend the nib or post the cap and extend the nib. I think I'm just used to a design like the Pilot Vanishing Point or the Platinum Curados or the Lamy Dialogue 3, which have retractable nibs and are capless. You just extend the nib and you're good to go. But the extending of the nib on this pen is such a fun experience. It is incredibly smooth and feels like a mechanism that's built to last a lifetime. It is quality craftsmanship. So for me, the fun outweighs the annoyance, and I've really enjoyed testing out this pen. In regard to price, I mentioned it up top, but this line has been discontinued since around 2014. So every once in a while, you might come across some new old stock, but for the most part, you're only going to find these on the secondary market. And the prices can vary greatly depending on the model and the gemstone. Some of the stones were more desired than others. I've seen versions of this pen available for $300 all the way up to $1,500. So if you're interested in this pen, I would strongly advise shopping around until you find the version you're looking for at the most reasonable price. Thanks again. Go out to Spencer for the loan of this pen for review. I appreciate being able to get a closer look at it. Now it is time for some measurements, some size comparisons, a look at the very cool cartridge loading mechanism, and a writing sample. Here we go with some size comparisons for the Mont Blanc Bohème. In regard to some other Mont Blanc pens, here it is with a 146, and here it is with a 149, and then finally here it is with a Mont Blanc Hitchcock. In regard to some non-Mont Blanc pens, here it is with a Pilot Vanishing Point and a Pelican M805. And then finally, here is a Sailor King of Pen Pro Gear. In regard to uncapped comparisons, I'll do it without the pen being posted. This is what it looks like in regard to the M805 and the 149 and then the 146. Okay, I wanted to show you this cartridge mechanism here. It is very cool. First of all, what you do is you hinge this open. And one of the cool things about here is it says do not remove under here. But you can see here, I'll get it in the right light, that the hole there is in the shape of the Mont Blanc star, which is kind of cool. But what you do is once you have the this hinged open, you go ahead and twist. Well, you have the nib closed, and then what you do is you twist, and when you twist it, then the cartridge comes out, and then you can remove the cartridge, and then you load up a new cartridge, and it's almost like a torpedo, like from a submarine, how you load it in there and then twist it and it retracts, and then you can go ahead and shut this, and then you extend the nib and you are good to go. But I just think that was a pretty cool mechanism. So here we have the Mont Blanc. Bohème. This is a medium 18 karat gold nib, and the ink that I'm using is today is from Laban and is their Artemis Navy Blue. This is what the ink looks like. It's a nice deep navy blue, fairly saturated, very similar to something like Diamine Oxford Blue, and slightly darker than one of my favorite blues, which is the Ackermann Shocking Blue. This is what the bottle looks like. This is the 50 milliliter bottle. Has a really nice large neck to it, so you can get just about any pen in here, and the bottle's fairly deep. Okay, here we go with the rest of the writing sample. As I mentioned, Mont Blanc has some fantastic nibs, and this nib is no exception. It is fairly smooth with a bit of good feedback to it. That the ink flow on this nib is decent. And in regard to reverse writing, it's very nice. It's not too sharp, and it lays down a nice extra fine line. In regard to some fast writing, the feed has no issues in keeping up. So there we have the Mont Blanc Bohème. Let's go ahead and just retract that and extend it a couple of times. This is just a very cool mechanism. So it's one that you'll find yourself playing around with. But I think this is an interesting pen. I know they discontinued it a while ago and it's rather difficult to find, but that I think there was a lot of positives about this pen, and I can understand why it was so popular for such a long period of time. So until next time, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you later.